Hi there. My name is Mike McGrory, and I'm going to admit to you right up front that I suffered from outhouse envy. I really did. My neighbor across the street had an outhouse for years. It's an old farmhouse, and there was always an outhouse behind it. And I thought that it would be a good idea to have my own outhouse. But today, you can't hardly build an outhouse, the zoning and everything else. So I had finally found a way to build an outhouse that I could actually have in my backyard. So let's take a look at the outhouse that I built for myself. Here it is. This is my pride and joy. This is an outhouse that doubles as a gardening shed or a potting shed. And I've added a lot of different, I've improvised and recreated the old-fashioned American outhouse. So basically what we've done is I've got a board up here where I hang my gardening tools, which is kind of nice because these are things that we use quite a bit, but trying to find them or trying to get your hands on them in my bigger tool shed was kind of a pain. My outhouse is actually a two-seater, at least it's designed to look like a two-seater. If you can see the bench in here in the outhouse. But what we did is we use this as storage. This is a slow-release fertilizer that we use here in our little backyard nursery. On this side, I've got a granular pre-emergent herbicide that we use for weed control. So basically, I found a way to create the bench and also to make it versatile, and so it's functional at the same time. So the idea with this video is to show you how I built this and how to build one yourself. If you'd like to, you know, if you're interested in this type of a structure. Well, we're going to move around to the sides because this outhouse actually has four sides. It's a four-door outhouse. So we're going to take a little break and then we're going to come back in for a second. Okay, a couple minutes ago we were standing and looking at the front of the outhouse. So now we have moved to the left-hand side of the outhouse. This is another little door on the outhouse. Actually, this is a little storage area. I have it filled with pots because we use this as a potting shed. This would be a good place to put, if you have gardening chemicals, if you use chemicals in your garden, you could put them in here, and you could actually put a hasp and a padlock on there. That way those garden chemicals would be secure. That's another option for here. And we're going to get out of here, and then we'll go around and to the back of the outhouse. Okay, now here this is the back of our outhouse, and this area back here is designed so that it can actually be used to store some tools. Once again, the things that we use most often, a spade, a fork, a shovel, rake, anything that you want to use this for. But there's another board in here if you actually wanted to hang a few more gardening tools or hand tools on here. So that's what the backside, that's what we have available on the backside of our little outhouse. Now let's move to the most interesting side, which is the right-hand side of our outhouse. Okay, this is the right-hand side of our outhouse. One of the things that I added here is I've actually built into this outhouse a string dispenser. So if you're looking for a piece of string to use around the garden, you just pull out what you want and cut it off. I actually put two different flavors of string here so that we can, because a lot of times if you're going to use something that might go in your compost pile or is going to go back into the earth, this is a sisal type twine. It's biodegradable. You don't have to worry about it. But a lot of times if you're tying up brush or something and you need something a lot stronger, you need something like this nylon twine. So that's why and trying to find a piece of string always seems to be a pain when you need it. So I built it in. I got a little string dispenser. This thing will actually hold thousands of feet of string. And so one bale of string would probably last you a lifetime. So there's my little string dispenser that I built in here. Now this side of the outhouse, actually, I've got a built-in potting bench. And a lot of times around here at our backyard nursery, we've got thousands of plants. One of the plants that we grow is a Japanese red maple. And if you want to pot up a few things here and there, we've got this potting bench. Now, inside of the outhouse, I've actually built a hopper or a storage bin that stores potting soil. So you can actually pot something up, and you got a little scoop. So it actually works. It works pretty good. You don't have to set up a potting bench, or you're not down on your hands and knees in the dirt working. And just like that, and as you use the soil, more soil falls down in. And that actually holds a significant amount of potting soil. And then when you're all done, you just sweep that off, close the door, close this little trap door here, and clean up the soil and close it back up. And again, you're right back to your nice-looking outhouse again. Thank you very much. Go to freeplants.com and sign up for my free gardening newsletter. Thanks a lot.